Hello, I'm Mr. Arnigar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist. I've been to the university to study the dead letters of the Old and the New Testament and turn out to be drunk with the old wine and not suitable for taking the new wine on top. So people who are not have studied theology at the universities and colleges, they are the best people to know gospel, because gospel is known through common sense, and which is the Holy Spirit, which the shepherd possessed, and good news of the birth of Jesus was given to them and not to the university professors in Jerusalem, who were his staunch enemies, as the University of Oxford, which is nearby, and our Reading University here, they don't like me. They have banned their chaplaincy to me. So here is the prediction based upon New Testament. Is Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30 getting fulfilled. So the planet Earth is for the habitation of the sons of Adam. They are under races. Under races they have tribes. And that's why 144,000 that would be saved are all mentioned by tribes and not as Jews. So under God come the spirituality, which is Jew, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, etc. And they are never born, they never die. Tribal people are born, tribal people die. So led by their blind guide, which made them fanatic, they make them Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Jew outwardly. And they make them fanatic, and they kill each other, sectarianoids, as it happened in India in 1947. My father knew the subject. 2,000 people came to attack our village because they were Mohammedan and we were Sikhs. And when my father told them that we tribal people going to kill each other and not Sikh and Muslim, they are spiritual self. And if there's an enmity between our tribes, we are ready to settle it. He said, no, there's no enmity, we are friends. And then he told the 2,000 people to look after us as their guest, which they did. This is the power of gospel. So if you hate gospel, you cannot survive. These guides, these mullahs, rabbis and all these people, the religious people, to get rid of them, Jesus died on the cross. And in Jesus, everyone has to give his own account to God. And in Jesus, God teaches us, not the men. Men teaches them in the universities and colleges, the dead letters, and they turn out to be super dead, burying the dead in the debates. So here is the royal kingdom. This is below John the Baptist. He baptized Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham, and Jesus in the name of his heavenly father Yahweh. And then here the rabbi, they boost the ego of the person, and that ego is to be buried. Seed is to be buried and turned into plant that will bear fruit, and the plant is Christ born. And then you enter this narrow gate on solitary basis and come here into the royal kingdom of God, where your soul is concerned and not your flesh. So neither male nor female, not Jew nor Gentile, we are all the sons of the Most High. One father, and we are all his sons. Son represents father, not the daughter. So that's why St. Thomas said, unless a female be a disciple, as Saul was disciple of Gamaliel, he was female. Whatever Gamaliel told him, he did it. Unless a female becomes a solitary male, she cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God. So we are fishers of men, not of women. We are all men twice born. So there are very few twice born people. So 1 in 1,000 and 2 in 10,000. So you can see how much they are. So this is the Satan, which is very powerful, working today. This is Al-Jamar Al-Aqsa. It is leaning against a hillock. But in the Hajj rite, this hill has been removed. All the significance of this gone. So they are pillar like this, the other two, which is wrong. So it has two names, Al-Kubra and Al-Aqsa. This is very powerful in the name of religion, Jew, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, etc. They create sectarian riots and they kill each other. So Jesus came to deliver the knowledge of the oral Torah, but the rabbis, the men of dead letters, they loved the scripture. So this is the moral teacher, Matthew 13 verse 52. He is the owner of a house synagogue, who bringeth forth treasures old, which is scripture, passed on from generation to generation. And the new, which is the knowledge of the oral Torah, are his word, you see through revelations are through logical reasoning. That proves logo. A logo is his word. For example, people of Judah tribe, Benjamin tribe, Levi tribe, they were led by the blind guide. And they died during the Holocaust under Hitler. So not a single Jew died, because a Jew is never born. And how can he die? It is the people of Judah tribe, Benjamin, Levi tribe. They were born, they died during the Holocaust, led by their blind guide. And that is sin. So Hitler killed the sinner. And Super Hitler, Putin, is going to kill the blasphemer. Saddam Hussein had weapon of mass destruction. They were none at all. So Tony Blair and Bush, they spoke blasphemy against the Holy Spirit and destroy one country after the other. So blasphemy is not forgivable, it's punishable by God, and God is going to punish it in the atomic war. So there you are. With this introduction, let's carry on with the what I have written, so you can understand it better. I have many videos, but the YouTube, they remove my video because the gospel truth is bitter and people start objecting to my views and they have to remove it as a hate. They call it a hate. And same when Jesus was preaching in the temple, his speeches were called by the temple priest, hate priest, hate preaches, hate speakers, hate speaking. So that's why they did not like him. Same way as here, you know, I go to Oxford University, they don't like to listen to me, because what I say is the what is written in the parable puzzles. hidden in the parable. Like the five husbands of the Samaritan woman, they were not physical, they were spiritual, and they have no idea of that. So when I tell them these names, they don't like it. They call me a heretic. So I am a retired university lecturer in metallurgy, hailing from Punjab, India, where the second coming of Christ, which we call Satguru in my native language, Jesus, in the name of Christ, Satguru Jesus, in the name of the second coming was Christ and Satguru, Nanak Dev Ji. He was a Satguru, people call him a Guru. Guru means a moral teacher, like a rabbi, Brahman. So that is the people in India. They are kings and emperors of darkness, so they have misled the people too much. So it took place in 1469 he came, second coming of Jesus, among the most greedy and satanic people. So people of India, they are very satanic, people of the Khatri tribe. So through five more lives, he preached the gospel to perfection for over 150 years. Still the darkness could not be comprehended. Thus four more lives, the royal kings came to protect the Sikhism and promoted the rule of righteousness. They have no intention of occupying the land, but to establish a rule of righteousness. The greediest kings and emperors of darkness still carried on with their satanic activities as mullahs in the mosque. So the Khatri, they became mullah in the mosque, and they created all that satanic activity and killed the last Christ on the earth, which was Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji. The Kashmir is the epicenter of these satanic mullahs. The New Testament has good information on what is going on. New Testament Christ Jesus is based upon this promised land. Promised land is the land which Yahweh created, and he brought Abram from the Iraq area to come and settle in the Middle East as Adam, Sarah as Eve, and he gave them the promised land as the Garden of Eden. And through them we learn all the moral laws. So it makes it very easy to understand what's happening in the world now. The New Testament has a good information on what is going on. In fact, Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30 is getting fulfilled, and the tares, the Jews, Muslims, etc., outwardly are getting bundled up in Israel for the final burning through atomic bombs. So the tares, the sons of the Satan, they will burn and kill each other. As you can see, them only this planet Earth is for the tribal people and not for Jew, Hindu, Sikh or Muslim. That's why 144,000 that would be saved, they're all mentioned by tribes and not as Jew or anything like that. Now these university theologians are dead in letters of the holy books, totally incapable of understanding the parable puzzles that only you learn through intuition, that the illiterate shepherd and farmers were able to do, as God is inside them. All of them are God-fearing. The university professors, another thing, they are not God-fearing. In the churches, they work for mammon. And at the end of the month, They want their salary. The first church, when it was found, people sold their possessions to enter that one. And here you are, they are looking for mammon, opposite. So what do you expect from them? So in Christ Jesus, we are royal priests and we have fellowship, and not these churches. So now these university theologians are dead in letters of the holy books, totally incapable of understanding the parable puzzles that only you learn through intuition. That the illiterate shepherd and farmers were able to do so, as God is inside them. They are always God-fearing, and so they were capable of learning the gospel truth, because they were desiring. Inside them and taught them, were able to do as God is inside them and taught them, which the greedy temple, which temple was the wine press, which the Jesus gave the last parable, wine press, the moral wine press coining the moral laws. Priests are the husbandmen, loving mammon more than God, could not understand. So they were greedy people, you know, in the temple. And that's why people make a hue and cry for our Father to send his own son. That's he summarized all his things in Jesus in the parable of the wine press. That is why Jesus did not throw pearls before swine in Jerusalem. In Jerusalem they wanted a sign or miracle, and Jesus refused to perform it because they were not believing, as the born blind person of John 9 of age. And Jesus opened his eyes and he went to the rabbi to pay them the homage. And they said, you are not the same person who was blind, you are different. And then they called his parents, and his parents were so frightened of them that they won't say anything. They say, he is of age, ask him. And you know what he told them, do you want to become the disciple of Christ Jesus? So that type of ruling they were, you know, absolute nonsense. And today you can find in churches and other people, the ruling, they killed people. This Pope is Antichrist. The Pope is the husbandman of the wine press, whom Jesus pointed his finger. And he established as Pope and priest and all things, the temple practices. I have put these things in other videos. As the two further, you know, did not throw pearls before swine in Jerusalem, as the two men in Gennesaret, two saints, you know, in Gennesaret were doing, and ended locked up in the silence of the graveyard, so that no one should listen to them, as the Oxford University professors of theology are doing to me. They don't want to listen to me. So they were locked up with heavy chains in the silence of the graveyard, but the Holy Spirit was setting them free. What Jesus has set free, nobody can bind him. Cutting the matter short, the atomic war is expected to take place soon after 14 November 2023. This is how I have calculated it. Israel was established on 14 May 1948. Add to activate 70 years of full protection. 70 is 10 times 7. 10 are the religious qualities and 7 are the type of works we do. 6 secular, the Sabbath spiritual, middle candle of menorah. On 14 May 2018, Israel was 70 years old and Donald Trump declared Jerusalem to be the capital of Israel and had moved his embassy in Jerusalem. Now there were 5 years of grace of heart in the name of Christ Jesus, which ended on 14 May 2023. And Israel declared that the whole Jerusalem belonged to Israel. This has boiled up the situation. And the Mohammedan, Hamas, Fatah, Hezbollah, etc., you know, have reacted against this announcement. Because this mosque, Al-Aqsa, which is the place where the holiest of holy temples used to be, it used to have a curtain around it. The holiest of holy temple is below the other one, you know, which is the temple of Yahweh, where the Judah Iscariot threw 30 shekels. And people were doing trading and other things. Jesus kicked them out. He whipped them out of the temple, turned their tables and other things. That was his father's house, heavenly father. The sons of the Most High, Satan, Al-Jamar, Al-Aqsa, super bastard, religious fanatic devils, John 8, verse 44. Jews and Muslims outwardly have become the staunch enemy of each other. Neither the Jews nor the Hamas and the Fatah can build their covenants with Abraham of the Semitic race. St. Paul has stressed many things, such as a Jew is one who is inwardly spiritual, never born and never died, and not outwardly are the tribal self, Judah, Levi, Benjamin, etc., that are born and will die, led by the blind guides, the rabbis. In India, three satanic lalas, Lala Gandhi, M.K. Gandhi, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, a Baniya of tribe Baniya, Lala Tara Singh Malhotra, a Malhotra Khatri, tribe Khatri tribe, and Lala Muhammad Ali Jinnah, a Babla Patiya, another shopkeeper, did the same sectarian riots with full collusion of the British hypocrites. So British hypocrites, they helped them. So here are my calculations. Israel was established on 14 May 1948 plus 70 years of full protection till 14 May 2018 when Donald Trump declared that Jerusalem is the capital of Israel. Then the five are the temptations of heart, well known in India. They are calm, immorality, krodh, anger, lobe, greed, moh, worldly attraction, and finally, hankar, haughtiness, you know, proud of the book knowledge, as the university professors are. They cannot know gospel. So this is it. All these are five temptations of the heart, are the evil things of the heart. This grace of our supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Pabram, etc., takes us to 14 May 2023, 5 years from 18. people who are going to perish are the creation of Yahweh, governed by the seven-candled menorah. So let us give 6 months of grace to, in the name of Yahweh. And that would take us to 14 November 2023. Next month, the seventh month, is of the middle candle of menorah called Shamash, sun, the primary source of light, the Christ or Elohim. So the seventh month is in the hand of Elohim, who is the overall father of creation, because the soul comes from him. This pot was made by Demiurge Yahweh. The soul inside me is of Elohim. So without soul, this pot is dead. So the soul is the master of this pot. This pot is created by Yahweh. That's what King David, you know, expressed it. Creation as supernatural soul is in all living things. King David said, my Lord Yahweh said to the Lord, Lord of Sabbath, the middle candle of the menorah, Shamash, as Jesus too declared that he is the Lord of Sabbath. Only he knows which day of the month the atomic war will take place, so he knows them. Thus, men taught by men, the dead scriptures in the universities and colleges, producing licensed dog-collared priests, cannot know God without the Holy Spirit, which is common sense, called Surti in Punjabi. But the illiterate shepherds and farmers have the common sense, and they know God. That is why the good news of the birth of Yeshua, the firstborn of Yahweh. Yeshua is made of two words, Yah from Yahweh, and Shoah or Shiva means the first primordial Adam. And the second Adam was given to the, good news of the birth of Jesus was given to the shepherds and not to the professors in the University of Jerusalem, the temple priest, who were his killers. So they were the husbandmen of the time, wine press, which was the university, coining moral laws. So much more I can tell, but the YouTube, you know, YouTube will remove my videos, and they call it a hate speech. In Jerusalem temple, Jesus' speeches were called hate speech by the temple priest. And so are these YouTube people doing to me. Never mind, God knows better than men. Our Father God blesses everyone in agape, unconditional divine love.